So this video is on a fairly outrageous topic, the primary confusion of the modern world. You might say the world's confused in many ways. You might say a primary one would be possessions, or what define us and lead to happiness. There's a big confusion. That's an important one. Another one, however, for this video, the confusion of the separation of power and love. There's various people that have talked about this. Kahane, I think, was one guy who wrote a book about it. My own teacher, Paul Linden, has looked at this in The Body. So what do I mean by this? We could talk about force rather than power. We could talk about kindness or compassion rather than love. Seeing these things as polar opposites, seeing these things as two sides of a spectrum. So what this leaves us with is a really shitty choice, yeah? So either we're like tough and strong and effective, you know, we're business effective, we're effective in life, we're strong, but we're mean, we're kind of jerks, we're assholes, or we're really nice people, we're super kind, super compassionate, but we're weak and we're ineffective and we're broke. There's another one, money, no money. We're broke and we're pushovers, yeah? So we think we either have to be effectively pushy or ineffectively being a pushover, or, you know, kind, love, power, two ends of the spectrum. This is actually, no one ever says this to us, but it's so implicit in culture that it's just there the whole time, like normal Mr. Nice Guy, yeah? We think that this is the case. Actually, as a martial artist, I can prove fairly quickly and conclusively this isn't the case. That if I tighten and contract, for example, I might feel strong, but that's actually very weak. I go off balance, for example. People are angry, they go off balance. People are scared, they go off balance. If I go tense up, it's not strong at all. And there's various demonstrations of that you can see if you look at Paul Linden's channel, for example. In politics, we see this same thing. You know, we have to be tough, we have to bomb them, we have to tell them, you know, we're strong, you know, oh, we're nice, and we try and make friends with everyone, and then they completely abuse us and push us over. So this distinction between power and love, not as opposite ends of a spectrum, but it's possible to both. Actually, same sides of the same thing, yeah? So not opposite things, but actually different sides of the same thing. By becoming more loving, we become more powerful. By becoming more truly powerful, as opposed to abusive, we become more loving. Yeah, easy to prove in the body. You know, we can structure this, you know, do a yoga posture and get tight, get hateful, see what happens, see how strong it is. Don't have to believe me. Do a punch, hit a punch bag, yeah? Do it with a sense of really feeling love and openness, see how strong that punch is. This is a very concrete, it's a very concrete thing we can experience. So the primary confusion, and people not realizing how to be loving and strong. And you can just do that as an inquiry, like standing or walking. I do this with clients all the time. It's like, okay, how would it be to be both strong and loving? How would it be to be really powerful right now, but also to be open, to be kind, to be compassionate? What if we didn't have to choose? What if they were two sides of the same thing? So, profound, lots of ways to explore it. Power and love.